Okay, so these are all the pedals that I've built so far, all the finished ones anyway. Got quite a few more I haven't boxed up yet, but anyway, I guess I'll just go down the line. This first pedal here, I call it the Jerry sound. It's a envelope filter. It also has a switch here, makes it work kind of just like a normal filter without the envelope. But anyway, it's based on a Tim Escobedo's Phuncgnosis pedal, which, I mean, it works okay. It's not as close to the Jerry sound as I'd like it to be. Jerry used a Mutron envelope filter, and I mean this does a good job, but it doesn't quite have the response that I was hoping for. But it works. I like it. Good for funk. The next pedal here is based on, or it is a Tim Escobedo's Pushme-Pullyou pedal. It works pretty good. I didn't add a volume knob on it because I was lazy at the time, but it's good. It's an octave fuzz pedal, makes your guitar sound like Jimi Hendrix on the Band of Gypsies album, which is a fun effect. This next pedal here I call the Comrade Oppressor Compressor. This is John Hollis's Flatline compressor, which does a really good job of compression. You kind of lose a little bit of the high end, but it still works. It does what it's supposed to do, and I like it. This one with Chairman Mallon here I call the Long March Overdrive. This is a DoD 250 overdrive pedal, which is actually I like quite a bit. It's got a good range. It gives a good clean boost, but also adds some crunch if you turn the gain all the way up. This one right here I called the Relapse pedal with William S. Burroughs on there. This is based on the Rebote 2.5 delay pedal, which uses a I forget the name of the chip, like a PT2366 chip. And forgive me if I'm wrong. It's been a while. I made this one about a month ago, which it does pretty good. It's not the cleanest, delay pedal there is. I'm gonna try to build another one, but it does a pretty good job for what it is. I'm pretty stoked about it. It's my first delay pedal that I've built, and I like it. This one right here I built for my girlfriend's sister. My girlfriend named it. She called it Stranger Danger. It's kind of an inside joke for her twin sister, but it's based there. It's not based on. It is a clone of a Devi Ever Sodomizer pedal, which is a really, really heavy fuzz pedal. It's pretty intense. This one here I called the Cogito Ergo Tremolo. I think therefore a tremolo pedal. Kind of a cheesy name, I know. This is a tremolo pedal that's my own design. I'm still kind of working out some kinks, and it does the job. But I just need to swap out the speed pot for just kind of a smaller value of resistance. But it works. It's a good tremolo pedal. This one here is kind of an experiment. I call it the Lightning Bolt pedal. It has artwork from the drummer from Lightning Bolt. If you guys don't know Lightning Bolt, it's a noise rock band. They're really friggin' heavy, and this kind of gives you like extreme noise. What it is a triple thing modulator pedal. It has you turn this switch on here, and it's a single thing modulator, which is like a really dirty ring modulator sort of effect. And so you can turn this one, and this one turns on a one thing modulator, and this switch right here controls a double thing modulator. So you can have one on or two on, or you could have three on at the same time for really insane noise. And not the most useful pedal, but I just wanted to build it because I built a couple of things in the past. It's essentially based on the noise 567 circuit, and they're kind of fun. They're really simple to build. If you like a really ugly ring modulator sort of a sound, they do a pretty good job. But this, I just wanted to build a pedal that was as ridiculous as it could be. And then going down the line here, this I call the Robo Boogie. It's another sort of ring modulator pedal, also I guess a Bitcrusher, but it's a clone of a Catalinbread Heliotrope, which is pretty interesting pedal. Yeah, I have lots more pedals I've built so far, a lot more fuzz circuits. These are just the ones that I have finished in with artwork and boxes, and they're all lacquered up and looking shiny and stuff.